Mr. Pine is the alderman for the transport of Hollyhock City. The traffic is badly congested again, and he can smell the vehicle exhaust fumes. The city's economy and population are expanding more rapidly than he can build new infrastructure. Air quality is also a priority for Hollyhock City, so Mr. Jones incentivizes car owners to switch to electric vehicles with a substantial rebate on the purchase costs, free parking, and a charging pole in front of their home. Miss Primrose, CEO of this distribution network, has worries about electric cars and warns him about the necessities to reinforce the electric grid in the city. She also suggests equipping public parking spaces and office parking lots with charging poles and to implement controlled smart charging to avoid overload on the local grid during the evening peak load hours. Mr. Willow, his alderman colleague for energy and climate, is enthusiastic about the electric car's plan. Battery electric vehicles are the missing link in his scheme, as he needs energy storage to deal with the variability of solar energy. He suggests linking the two technologies in a smart way, so that the batteries are charged during sunny times and discharged during times when renewable energy supply is slow. Mr. Pine realizes that there's a lot more electric cars than just replacing conventional cars. If he wants to combine air quality, sustainable energy, and climate policy goals in his plan, it will have to be smart and require a lot of IT support. He consults Mrs. Grapevine, CEO of the leading IT engineering business in Hollyhock City. She reassures him that all necessary IT elements have already been demonstrated. Mr. Pine decides to go ahead and present his smart e-mobility plan to the city council. After all, a livable city should do more to support public health than stimulating electric cars.